Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Tuesday of the 10th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Whom should I dread? When those who do evil draw near, they stumble and fall.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we who call on you in our need may at your prompting discern what is right, and by your guidance do it, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the first book of Kings. The brook near where Elijah was hiding ran dry, because no rain had fallen in the land. So the Lord said to Elijah, "Move on to Zarephath of Sidon and stay there. I have designated a widow there to provide for you." He left and went to Zarephath. As he arrived at the entrance of the city, a widow was gathering sticks there. He called out to her, "Please bring me a small cup full of water to drink." She left to get it, and he called out after her, "Please bring along a bit of bread." She answered, "As the Lord your God lives, I have nothing baked. There is only a handful of flour in my jar and a little oil in my jug. Just now I was collecting a couple of sticks to go and prepare something for myself and my son. When we have eaten it, we shall die." Elijah said to her, "Do not be afraid. Go and do as you propose, but first make me a little cake and bring it to me. Then you can prepare something for yourself and your son. For the Lord, the God of Israel, says, 'The jar of flour shall not go empty, nor the jug of oil run dry, until the day when the Lord sends rain upon the earth.'" She left and did as Elijah had said. She was able to eat for a year, and Elijah and her son as well. The jar of flour did not go empty, nor the jug of oil run dry, as the Lord had foretold through Elijah. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Lord, let your face shine on us.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
When I call, answer me. O my just God, you who relieve me when I am in distress, have pity on me and hear my prayer. Men of rank, how long will you be dull of heart? Why do you love what is vain and seek after falsehood?
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Know that the Lord does wonders for his faithful one. The Lord will hear me when I call upon him. Tremble and sin not. Reflect upon your beds in silence.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
O Lord, let the light of your countenance shine upon us. You put gladness into my heart, more than when grain and wine abound.
Lord, let your face shine on us.
Alleluia, alleluia. Let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "You are the salt of the earth, but if salt loses its taste, with what can it be seasoned? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand where it gives light to all in the house. Just so your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Alam niyo, napakaganda ng timing ng pagbalik natin sa ordinary time, no? That we are going back to the 10th week in ordinary time, no? So when we started the Lenten season, nung Ash Wednesday, we were ending the 9th week, no? So we resume now with the 10th week in ordinary time. So it's a very beautiful timing because we begin our Gospels taking it from the Sermon on the Mount, no? The fifth chapter of Matthew. And of course, even today's reading, no? The very first reading that we have in ordinary time, yesterday was the Feast of Mary, Mother of the Church, is about the salt of the earth and the light of the world, no? And I'd like to begin our reflection, magsimula tayo dun sa introduction sa prayers of the faithful. Sabi dun sa introduction, mamaya babasahin natin to ulit. Let us pray to God the Father of light, that you may be faithful to our mission of being the light and the salt of the world. Siguro ito yung gusto kong pagnilayan natin ngayong araw, no? Yung pagbabalik natin sa ating mission, yun yung panghuli natin na pagninilayan. Pero yung mission natin na maging asin at maging ilaw ng mundo. So pagnilayan natin yung dalawa, no? Yung salt at yung light at mission, no? No, when you take a look at the whole idea of salt, no, of course we've reflected on this the last 2 years, no, but you know during the time of Christ, salt was a very pure commodity, very held in high esteem, so to speak, no. Talagang pinupuri nila, gustong-gusto nilang asin nung panahon na yon. Because number one, it preserves. Diba? Alam naman natin yan na pag inasan mo ay paprotektahan siya sa pagkabulok. Ano? Pero meron din isa pang bahagi ang salt. No? Nakikita kasi yan, yung paniwala nila na isa sa pinakapurong elemento ang asin. Kasi saan siya nang galing? Sa dalawang elemento. Tubig ng dagat at ang araw. So it is from the sun and the sea. And that's why there's a certain purity in the element of salt. No? Of course, in our reflection, the element of salt preserves, but it also brings out the best in what it seasons, no? And siguro yun yung una nating mahalagang pagnilayan sa ating mission, na tayo inaanyayahan ng Diyos, at hindi tayo inaanyayahan, pero sinasabi sa atin ng Diyos na kayo ang asin ng mundo. You are the salt of the earth. Kayo ang asin ng mundong ito. And that for me is one of the greatest compliments of God for us. He believes that we will be able to preserve the goodness that he has created, and he believes that we will bring out the best in his creation, most especially in people. Siguro yung una nating pagnilayan, no? How do we bring out the best in others? How do we preserve the good that God has created? Paano natin pananatilihin ang kabutihan na ginawa ng Diyos sa mundo? At papaano natin palalabasin ang kabutihan, ang kagalingan, no, ng bawat isa sa atin. Maybe that first point to reflect on, no? To become agents of preserving the good that God has created and of inspiring others to be their best. You are the salt of the earth. Then the second is, you are the light of the world, no? Kagaya nga nung sinabi natin sa dun sa introduction, di ba? Let us pray to God, the Father of light, that we may be faithful to the mission of being light and salt. Remember, again, this is one of the greatest compliments of Christ. Why? Because remember, Christ is the light of the world. And for Christ to call us, you are the light of the world, he is almost saying that, kasama ko kayo, you are with me. You are part of my mission. And I think this is such a tremendous, not just challenge, but a tremendous compliment. And sana seryosohin natin yun, ano, na tayo ang ilaw ng mundo. At yung mission na yan, nanggagaling mismo sa Panginoon. No? Because He is the light of the world. That is what we celebrated during Easter. Christ, the light of the world. And now, as we enter ordinary time, we are being asked to be light of the world. And what does that mean to us? What does that mean to you in living out our lives in the day-to-day? And again, no, as I've invited you to reflect on this during the Easter season. How do we live out all of these graces, all of the things that we pray over, all of the things that we pray about, to be truly light of the world, like Christ is light of the world, in a world filled with so much darkness? Paano tayo magiging ilaw kagaya ng Panginoon? At yung pangatlo't huling punto ng ating pagninilay, simple lang, no? Lagi kong sinasabi na ang pinakamahalagang bagay sa mundong ito ay malaman ng ating misyon. And I want to reiterate that as we go into ordinary time. As we go into ordinary time, I hope we go into ordinary time with a renewed sense of mission. And that sense of mission is what at the end of today's gospel is telling us. For us to do good, for us to be light of the world, not to attract attention to ourselves, but others may see the glory of God, the goodness of God through us. Yun yung mission. It is to proclaim God as the light of the world. It is to proclaim God as the one who has overcome all the darkness of evil and sin. That is our mission. It is to give glory to God. And I pray that as we move into ordinary time, part of the grace, the day-to-day grace that we will pray for, and that at the end of the day, I hope we can turn to God and say, Lord, all this for your greater glory. Yun yung ating mission. In all things, to love and to serve the Lord and to give Him greater glory. Yun ang mission natin. Panginoon Diyos, para sa iyong kalawalhatian lahat ito. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray to God, the Father of light, that we may be faithful to our mission of being the light and the salt of the world. To each prayer, our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may show the power and radiance of the Spirit to all seeking the truth, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the brilliance of the Gospel may enlighten men and women entrusted with decisions for the development of peoples, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we, called to be salt and light of the world, may become a source of hope and comfort to our fellow men. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us now offer all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us now offer our post-election prayer. Diyos aming Ama, nagtitiwala kami sa iyong pangako na magpapadala ka sa amin ng mga pinunong naaayon sa iyong puso at diwa. Panginoong Hesus, bigyang inspirasyon mo ang lahat ng aming mga bagong pinuno na maging mga pinunong tagapaglingkod. Nauunahin ang higit na nakabubuti para sa higit na nakararami, lalong-lalo na ang mga mahihirap, mga nasa laylayan at mga mahina. Higit sa anumang interes sa pansarili o para sa grupo, mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na tunay na maghahangad na maglingkod at hindi paglingkuran. Mga pinunong tagapaglingkod na may integridad at tunay na malasakit. Banal na Espiritu, tanglawan ng aming mga isip at puso ng aming makita ng malinaw ang mga tunay na pangailangan ng aming mga kapwa Pilipino at panagutin ng aming mga bagong pinuno upang tunay silang mamuno at maglingkod. Mga pinuno ayon sa iyong sariling puso at diwa at mga pinuno na magbubuklod at mamumuno sa amin upang gawin naming lahat kung anong higit na nakabubuti para sa higit at nakararami at para sa iyong higit na kalawalhatian. Ama, Anak at Espiritu, ikaw ang Diyos ng buhay at pag-ibig, ang Panginoon ng kasaysayan. Naway makasama ka namin sa pagbabagong ito at panibagong simula. Amen. Birhen ng Fatima,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
Immaculada Concepcion, patron ng Pilipinas,
ipanalangin niyo po kami.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer, fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. They will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Look kindly upon our service, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer may be an acceptable oblation to You, and lead us to grow in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, His resurrection we confess with living faith, and His coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father most holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. Together now, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we confess our sins and we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to seek your protection against COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you to look upon us with love and by your healing hand dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Bless our efforts to use the medicines developed to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers, that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. May your healing work, O Lord, free us, we pray, from doing evil and lead us to what is right, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And let us now offer our prayer for Ukraine and Russia. We fly to your patronage, O Virgin Mother of God. Despise not our prayers in our needs, but deliver us from all dangers, since you alone are pure and blessed. O most glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of Christ our God, accept our prayers and present them to your Son and our God, that for the sake of you enlighten and save our souls. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our Lady, Queen of Peace,
pray for us, especially the people of Ukraine, and pray for the conversion of Russia.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us, especially the people of Ukraine, and pray for the conversion of Russia.
Divine mercy,
have mercy on us, especially the people of Ukraine.
Prince of Peace,
have mercy on us, especially the people of Ukraine, and touch the hearts of the Russian soldiers.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat. Have a good day ahead. Thank you.
Mga kababayan, ang biyaya ng muling pagkabuhay ni Jesus ay mapasa inyo. Dahil sa inyong pakikisa sa ating panawagan na tulong, patuloy tayong nakapagpapadala ng pagkain, nagbibigay ng tulong pangkabuhayan, at nagpapatayo ng mga bahay. Subalit marami pa rin ang nangangailangan ng ating pang-alay kapwa. Hanggang Mayo 31, tayo po ay magkawanggawa para sa mga pamilyang apektado ng bagyo at ng iba pang sakuna. Maraming salamat muli at Happy Easter!